Bonjour. Comment allez-vous? Hello, how are you? Comme vous déjà savez que je m'appelle Dhananjay Dhondial. As you already know that my name is Dhananjay Dhondial. Et je suis un professeur de français. And I am a French teacher. Et j'essaye mon mieux de vous enseigner quelque chose en français. And I am trying my level best to teach you something in French. Alors, aujourd'hui, on va discuter de les règles de phonétique. And today we are going to discuss about the rules of phonetics. Alors, c'est la deuxième vidéo de moi, tant que cette partie est concernée. Well, this is the second video of mine as far as this part is concerned. Dans mon premier vidéo, je vous ai déjà enseigné quelques règles de phonétique. I have already taught you in my previous video some rules of phonetics. Et aujourd'hui, on va faire et on va discuter, on va comprendre les restes de règles de phonétique. And today we are going to study the rest part of the rest rules of the phonetics. So if you want to study, you know, or if you want to learn the meaning of the diphthong, you can see my previous video. And that I have explained you what is diphthong and all that. So here we'll continue with it. On va continuer avec ça. We are going to continue. I mean, we are continuing with that. So A E O N T I O N. Alors en français, ensemble T I O N, c'est prononcé comme chien. The French, in French, T I O N is together pronounced as chien. Et pour faire vous comprendre le mieux and for making you understand better, je vous donne quelques exemples. Par exemple, N-A-T-I-O-N. Alors, comment est-ce qu'on peut le prononcer en français? How can we pronounce it in French? N-A-N-A-T-I-O-N. I have already taught you here, together it gives xion sound. Now you compose all the syllables together, so it will be what? Na-xion. Na-xion. Na-xion, c'est pareil en français mais en anglais. It's the same in French and in English. Nation. Alors, I-N, it gives a sound in French. So, I-N-D-E. How will you pronounce it? And the last E is mute. Thousand times I have told you this thing. So this is and. And means India. To India, they don't say India. They say and. By example, j'habite en Inde. For example, I live here in India. J'habite en Inde. Mon pays, ça s'appelle and. My country, its name is and. Et ce sont les questions pour vous, pour les prononcer. And these are the questions for you to pronounce. So if you are really interested, si vous êtes vraiment intéressé à apprendre le français, alors vous devez me répondre ces questions. If you are really interested in learning French, you have to answer these questions. How do you pronounce these two words? Okay, you can do it through comment box. Then we'll come to the next one, I am. It gives am sound, am. So like, am, to, R gives the or kh or ra sound. It is your choice. And ta and a and gives on sound. In my previous video, I have already taught you this thing. Last consonant is mu. So you compose all the syllables together. It is am, por, ta and on, ton. So important, important. C'est la chose très importante pour vous. This is a very important thing for you. Pour comprendre, for understanding. La langue française est très importante pour moi. French language is very important for me. La langue française est très importante pour tout, presque toutes les personnes. It is very important for almost all the persons. Okay, pas de problème. Then T-I-E-L. It together gives the sound like hiel. For example, I have already taught you, it gives am sound, am, bar, and this is hiel. So altogether it is am bar hiel, which means impartial. So here, impartial. In English we have A, in French we have E. So, you know, soyez, you know, prompt. You just be careful. Then we have T-I-E-S. It gives sound like shoe. By example, arm, B, and T-I-E-S, shoe. Altogether it is arm, B, shoe. Arm, B, shoe means ambitious. Ambitious. By example, vous êtes très ambitieux. For example, you are very ambitious. C'est pour cela où j'apprends le français. And that's why you are learning French language.
D'accord.
Et après ça, on a E-I. And after that, we have E-I. En français, on le dit E. In French, we say E. And I is E. I have taught you, you can go to my previous videos to see the alphabets. So E-I together gives sound like A. So like, you want to read this? This is SA, E-I gives A sound, and this is R, last is mu. So all together with SAVE. SAVE. SA plus A and Z. SAVE. That is 16. SAVE. So this is for you. If you have understood me, you will do it by yourself. It means 13. So how do you read it? Well, that's your job. And then this one. EN, I have already taught you in my previous video. You know, it gives what type of sound, that is what you will tell me. And then we have EI, and then even GN I have taught you in previous video, and then ER. So, how will you read it together? That's what you will tell me, and it means to teach. Then we have double L. Double L is mute in between I and E. Whenever you find double L in between I and E, it will be mute. But mind it, in between I and E, not in between E and I, in between I and E. So please, keep this thing in your mind. Par exemple, F-E-L-L-E. So here, we want to read this word. So it is, double N is coming in between I and E, so it is mute as per this rule. And the last E is already mute, that you know very well. So only this much will be pronounced, and you will read as Phi. You will write double N-E, but you won't pronounce it. Phi means girl or daughter. So this is your job to do. You know, you will read this, and you will read this. Yeah, I will see your talent. Well, this means family and this means air, Khan. Okay? But you know, don't press too long on a quelques exceptions. In almost all the languages, we have some exceptions. Exactement français, on a quelques exceptions. Et on voit les mémoires, and we have to just learn them, we have to just remember them. Bon. Bon. We have some exceptions here, and what is that? M-I-double-N-E. I just told you double N is muted between I and E, but here it is not. Why? On n'a pas la réponse pour ça. We don't have an answer for this. C'est pour cela. C'est une exception. And that is why this is an exception. So this is meal. Double N is not mute here. This is mute. And here this is veal. Double N should be mute, but it is not mute. It is an exception. Veal. Veal means city. Mean means 1000. Okay, then we'll move to the next one, and that is UI. UI together gives sound like we or we. So like S-U-I-E. So you will read it, you know, last one's already mute. So this is SA and UI together gives we sound. So all together it is SUI. SUI means AM. AM. By example, c'est SUI and YON. I am Indian. Je suis un professeur de français. I am a French teacher. Je suis un étudiant. I am a student. Bla bla bla. C'est comme ça. Et ce sont votre boulot. And this is your job to do it. You will just tell me how you pronounce these words. The meanings are already given here. And then we have the next one. EU. It gives sound. You have to protrude your lips like this. But do this practice only in your room. Okay, don't do it outside on the road. Okay, so it is slightly long. So like V-E-N-D-E-L-R-T-E-Q-L. We want to read it. This is V-E-N. In my previous video, I have already taught you. It gives en sound. So V-E-N-T-I-T. There is no T sound, but T sound. I gives E sound. So V-E-N Ti, vanti, vanti, la, and the, and this is a. As I told you, it is slightly long. So, vanti, la, the, and the a. Last consonant is mute, but in my first video, I have already taught you C, R, F, L, K, and Q. They are not mute, so they will be pronounced. So, R, original sound is R, and the other people who are not French, they read it as R. So, it is your choice. You can read as vanti, la, the. If not, then you can say ventilateur, which means fan, ventilateur. This is climatiseur. S coming in between vowel gives a sound a r. Altogether, climatiseur. Climatiseur is AC. In short, they say loclim. Loclim. In short, loclim ne marche pas. So, you know, AC is not working. Or loclim marche bien. AC is working well. Comme ça. Like that. So, c'est votre boulot de le faire. This is your job to do it. You tell me how to pronounce it, which means teacher. In French, Y. Y is considered as a vowel. In English, we have five vowels, A, E, I, O, U, mais en français, on a six. Six voyelles. We have six vowels. Et le sixième voyelle, ça c'est quoi? Y. And the sixth one is what? This one. Why? Because of its sound. It gives E sound. So it is S-T-Y-L-O, stylo. Y gives E sound, so stylo, stylo. Ça veut dire quoi? Pen. Stylo, pen. Okay, then we have G. It gives Z sound and G sound. When does it give Z sound? When it comes before E-I-Y. And when it comes before the rest, then it gives G sound. It's just like in English. You know, in English, how do you read it in English? Gesture. You never read it as gesture. Why? Because it is coming before E. And how do you read it as? You never read it as jod. You always read it as God. Why? Because it is coming before other than E-I-Y. So the same is the case here in French. Well, we want to read this word. So here it is coming before E. So it will give Z sound. And EN, in my last video I have already taught you, it gives ON sound. Last consonant is mute. So Z plus ON together gives ZON sound, which means people, public. Les gens ici à Dehradun sont très gentils. The people here in Dehradun are très gentils. They are very nice. But how do you read this one? You know, here it is coming before other than E-I-Y, so it won't give Z sound, then it will give G sound. And it is ga, ta, and in my previous video I have taught you EAU altogether gives like O sound. So you compose all the syllables, it will be gâteau. Gâteau, c'est quoi? Gâteau, c'est cake. C'est très délicieux, gâteau. Est-ce que j'aime le gâteau? You like gâteau? Oui, je pas bien sûr. I hope, yeah, definitely, I believe. Okay. Si vous m'avez compris, if you have understood me, alors, c'est la question de moi à vous. This is a question from my side to you. Pour le prononcer vous-même, for pronouncing it yourself, do it. And then tell me, to comment box. Thank you. Et, finally, à la fin, C, it gives S sound and K sound. When does it give S sound and K sound? Well, just like in English, you know, when it comes before E-I-Y, it gives S sound, or other than E-I-Y, it gives K sound. Like in English, you see, how do you read it? You never read it center, you always read it as center, center. Why? Why so? Because it is coming before E. Or, how do you read it? Cylinder, you never read it as cylinder, you read it as cylinder. Why? Because it is coming before Y. You know, how do you read it as cinema? No, cinema, it is coming before I. So, although you read, you know, these words like this only, correct? But maybe some of you people did not know or might not know that this is the region. So today you have come to the region. So with French, your English is also getting, you know, boosted up altogether. So same is the case in French. You know, here it is coming before E, so it will give sa sound, and EN already gives on sound. Last consonant is mu, so altogether it is song. Song means 100. Song. Say song rotis. I have 100 rupees. The next one, here it is coming before other than E-I-Y, so it will give what? It will give ka sound, and this is ka, the, E-A-U gives O sound, altogether it is ka do is gift, but when you actually hear French people speaking this, they read it like kya do, so every language has got two aspects, one is pure grammatical aspect, second is the colloquial aspect. So, you have to learn both. Colloquial aspect means like in, you know, in Hindi, if, you know, I want to say, वह आज नहीं आ रहा है. So, this is pure, you know, grammatical way of saying. But normally people say, वह आज यहाँ नहीं आ रहा है. We never say woha. Woha becomes wo. Nahi becomes ni. So this is the colloquial aspect. So we have to learn, no? Both, if you really want to survive, if you want to, you know, live, you know, comfortably in that community. Bon, alors, c'est tout pour aujourd'hui. Je crois que vous avez vous profité bien avec la leçon avec moi. I hope you must have enjoyed the lessons with me. Et si vous avez quelques problèmes de me demander, and if you have some questions to ask me, alors vous pouvez me demander fréquemment. Sans problème, you can ask me without any problem. Alors, merci beaucoup. Et si vous l'avez, les leçons vraiment, alors vous pouvez les partager avec les autres personnes. If you really like, you know, my videos, my contents and all that, you can share it with other people. Merci beaucoup. Au revoir. À bientôt. Hare Krishna.